Microplastics in blood, could it affect human health? Before, it was just dust everywhere, squishing itself in every nook and cranny. Now, plastics are everywhere as it is part of our daily items. From appliances to the very thing we wear, plastics and synthetic fibers are very common components of everyday products. Recently, a study revealed for the first time the presence of microplastics in the blood. Does it pose a health risk? Plastics come in many forms to make countless products today. While there are efforts to limit plastic use, we can't completely remove them from manufacturing. For example, paper bags for packaging items have been effective in controlling plastic use in retail. Yet plastic components in creating appliances, electronics, and clothing are not easily replaced. It will take time to find efficient and environmentally friendly substitutes. Why? The development itself hugs different phases. Next, scalable methods for mass production must be effective. Then, waiting for the prices to drop to the same level as the ones getting replaced. In the journal Environment International, researchers in the Netherlands revealed the discovery of plastic particles in human blood. This is alarming because plastic isn't friendly to organic life. Remember what's been happening in oceans, where marine life consumes plastic without knowing, feeling stuffed, and ending up dying due to toxic effects. With new evidence, experts are analyzing what tiny specks of plastics can do inside the human body. It's highly probable given the prevalence of microplastics in air, water, wildlife, the food chain, that they will also be entering the human body, but the technical difficulties of measuring microplastic particles in the human body has made it hard to confirm this. Chair of Ecotoxicology at the University of Exeter, Prof. Tamara Galloway, told Medical News Today. Using an innovative detection technique, researchers look for plastics that could be absorbed across membranes in the human body. They use glass fiber filters to avoid plastic contamination during the filtration of blood samples. Blood samples were filtered for plastic ranging from 700 to 500,000 nanometers. They filtered for five common plastics: poly or methyl methyl acrylate, polypropylene, polymerized styrene, and polyethylene terephthalate. Over three quarters of blood samples contain quantifiable levels of microplastics. Polyethylene terephthalate, typical in plastic bottles, accounted for more than half of tested blood samples. The researchers found zero polypropylene in those samples. Other blood samples were discovered with three of the five plastic types. The health effects of microplastics aren't fully known. A URV research showed that microplastics could destabilize the barrier around all cells, which might affect cellular function. Another study published in the journal Hazardous Materials linked microplastics to several effects like cell death. However, the effects of accumulating microplastics inside organs are yet to be discovered. Are you limiting your use of plastic? What measures are you doing to help protect the environment? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.